somebody like Jesus, and you know you there's a situation you get to in life, and then you've tried all the possible means to get yourself out of that situation, but definitely if you don't call on Jesus, there is no way you're going to get out of that situation. And that's what we're preaching on this particular program every Monday, 1:30 to 2:30 p.m. It's the Super Lunch Gospel Vibes right here on Super Screen Television. And ladies and gentlemen, we have a wonderful guest on set with us this morning. Beg your pardon, this lovely afternoon, and then she's going to be getting us into our world, and together we're going to be having a wonderful time. We're not wasting much of your time. So many time gone already. Join me as I make welcome no other person than Joe Diva. Good to have you.
Good to be here. Thank you so much.
Welcome to Super Lunch Gospel Vibes.
Thank you. It's lovely on set here.
Now, let me quickly start by asking you, nobody like Jesus. What is the inspiration behind that song? Now, we just saw the video of that right now, and I saw the camion appearance, and then we also realized that that particular music is really passing out a great message out there. But what is the rationale behind that particular song?
Wow, God is good, He's kind, He has mercy and joy forever. You know, when you know the favor of God and what God has done for you, you will know that there's nobody like the Lord. God has been so gracious and He has done so many awesome things for me. You know, with the kind of testimonies that I have.
So that song, sorry to cause that song has a personal experience with you?
Yes, it does, wow. It does. And even the video is a testimony.
Okay.
It came as, you know, if I can say, I can say that I didn't pay anything for that video.
Amazing.
So that is how gracious God is. So it's really, there's nobody like the Lord.
Certainly, there's nobody. But were you actually thinking about what you were going through at that point in time when you were writing that song?
Yeah, I was inspired by, you know, situations and, you know, circumstances you find yourself and you're trying, maybe there are needs, you may need something from people, and you find out that people that you actually hope on, at the end of the day,
they disappointed you.
And at the least, as in, you don't really, really expect anything, and God shows up at the 11th hour, that's when you know that there's nobody like
that. Quite amazing. So, Ify?
Yeah, being a woman, you put in your profile that you're a business leader and you're a woman. How do you feel you have been impacting women with your song? Have you been getting testimonies from other women, especially in the business world, knowing how what most people are talking about the business environment, saying things and haven't really been moving smoothly? How do you think your music has been touching the lives of women all over the world?
Well, first to start with, in my church, I'm the choir leader, and I have like 80 women that I'm leading.
Wow.
So, and these are ladies that some of them, before they got married, they were in a choir. So when they start giving birth and all that, you know, the structures and all that, they left the choir. So they find hope coming back to the choir. They know that actually, I can still do singing. I can still minister to God. It doesn't matter if I'm married. I shouldn't be stopped now. So I've had the opportunity to give so many of them platform and stage to really, really bring the best out of them, because the best is really in them. But because they weren't given the opportunity to showcase what they've got. So I've touched lives by the grace of God. And there are so many organizations, so many women organization conferences that we always have. You know, when I'm invited to make speech and all that, I believe I've touched lives.
Okay, so do you see yourself empowering women or giving them a
I empower women as I can.
Okay.
You know, there are some women out there that they might be in need.
Okay.
There are things they need. Maybe it could be financial support and all that.
Yeah.
I try my best to be there for them.
That's really impressive. Yeah.
Now let's look at, sorry to cut you, now let's look at you and the music. You've been doing music for how long now?
I've been doing music for like 6-7 years now.
Professionally.
Amazing.
And then you are a mother, a businesswoman, a choir minister, and now you're a gospel artist. How do you combine all those roles together and then you don't have any form of lapses in delivering all these obligations?
It's the Holy Spirit. It gives me the balance. It's not really, really easy.
Okay.
It's not really easy to put music, business, administration, everything together, especially when you're in a choir. You know, being in a choir is different from being in
music
minister.
Yeah, certainly.
Because when you're in a choir, you have to go for rehearsals and all the programs in church and all that. You know, putting this together, I just say it's grace.
Amazing.
Grace.
Amazing.
Yeah. Because if I have to say it's my power or the strength of all, whatever,
not at all.
It's not. It's grace. It's just God's grace.
So why did you choose music? You were actually in the line of business, okay?
Yeah.
And then what inspired you to go into music? Is it because you've had a background as a choir leader, or you just felt, oh, I have this wonderful talent of singing, I want to inspire life through my song? What inspired you to go into music?
I didn't even know I could sing, like, really? 6 or 7 years ago.
Okay.
I didn't know I could sing.
Even when you were in the choir?
No, I haven't joined the choir then.
Oh, okay.
I was just like a Christian. Then a cell leader brought me to Christ Embassy and I became a member.
Okay.
Then they now made me their choir leader.
Okay.
It was a satellite church. Then from there, I started developing, you know, how to sing. I then discovered that I could write, I could compose,
amazing,
and I could actually make a music,
amazing,
make a song. So it just came out from when I joined the choir. I discovered it.
Okay, and then since then you've not turned back.
No.
And it's been an amazing
journey. From glory to glory. Yeah,
yeah, from glory to glory. I actually love that. All right.
Yeah, for a startup, for those who are trying to get into music and things like that, can you just give them like a step-by-step process of producing? How many albums have you produced so far?
Just one album.
Just, okay, but at least there's someone who is saying that, I hope one day I'll be able to produce an album,
yeah,
I'll be able to do studio sessions and all that. Can you just give a vivid process of how to finally come out with an album?
Yeah, I'll actually say to those out there, maybe you have the dream that you want to have an album one day. I will not really say it's easy, but persistency and commitment will make you to get to where you want to be. Like, for instance, when I was planning to have an album, it didn't start one day. It started from recording a song, writing a song for the choir, you know, discovering that, you know, how to listen to the song. Will this song be good when you get to the studio, when you make the song, when it's now a recorded track? Is it going to do well? You have to know all these things. You have to put all these things together. So at the end of the day, you now get a song.
Yeah.
It's a single, yeah, you know. It's not. You can't use a single to have an album. At least the least to make an album is 10 tracks.
Okay.
So you now find out that, okay, you have to get a song, 2, 3, 4, 5. You know, you need all the grace, all the support, everything to get everything together, you understand?
Okay.
So when you have 2, 3, and the funny thing is that you don't have to have 10 songs to have an album. You have to get like 20 to 25 songs.
Then you pick the best.
Yeah, you pick the best. Okay. So you can see how the journey is not what you just start now and you get there. It takes a while.
Okay.
You know, by the time you get everything together and with the support of the people around you, you can actually do it.
What's a musical break? All right, and it's a special song, a special dedication, because we have amazing birthdays in the house and we are celebrating our admin, Madam Ogechi. We love you so much. Happy birthday from all of us. And it's a birthday shout out. The song is JK Car, okay, and it's titled Next Break. Okay, Next Break by JK Lynn Carr, okay.
And
happy birthday.
Just to add to that, our one and only JB is also celebrating his birthday today. Happy birthday to you, bro. I understand that you're fasting, but regardless, we still have something to munch today in the office. So we're wishing you guys, Madam Oge and JB, a fabulous birthday celebration today.
Yeah.
And I pray as you become a year older, every other thing that you need in life, God will just have them all to you. We love you guys so much, and we have dedicated this particular music to you guys. Just have fun wherever you are, and the moment we're done with this show, we'll come straight to your office to blast that place. So stay cool. The show continues after this break. Stay with us.
Wow.
Yes, you're welcome back. And that is to Madam Oge, and also to our very own JV. It's not Junior Boy, though. He's Jubril Hussein. And we're wishing you guys a very prosperous birthday. Bet they come once in every year. So today we are celebrating you guys. I just want to tell you guys to just feel cool and have a wonderful day, regardless of the weather. Okay, just feel cool and have a wonderful day. So we're talking with Jodiva. I said the Super Lunch Gospel Vibes right here on Super Screen Television, and we're having a wonderful conversation with Jodiva. Remember, you can call us on any of our phone lines I'm showing on your screen right now, and just say a word or two to her. You can just say hi and ask her any questions you have in mind. Now let's talk about you and music. Okay, you've been doing music for over 7 years now, and it's strictly gospel. I want to ask, okay, before you actually said you started off music from the choir.
Yeah.
Okay, so why do you choose gospel? Is it because you're in the choir, or you just felt, I want to use the gift to serve God? Wow. Well, there could be other reasons I don't know of. Why do you choose gospel music?
Wow. You know, when I got into the choir and I was doing choir things, I started making friends. And I have friends that was in bands, secular bands. So, you know, there's this temptation, like, okay, you want to, you're here, you're there, and all that. But I came to, you know, I made a decision that whatever my gift is for God.
Yeah.
So it's a decision, and it's a personal decision, what you want to do with the gift that God has given to you. So God called me to sing, and my voice is for God.
Amazing. So how's the reception been for you? For over 7 years, you've been doing this now.
It's been from glory to glory. Amen. Yeah.
So have you done any collaborations with any of the gospel?
Yes, I have. Yes, I did a collab with Obishine, and I did a collab with Benga.
Okay. What are the title of the songs?
Obishine, Blessing Me.
Blessing me.
That's the title.
Blessing
the
video me.
Yes, deliver. No, the video is not out. Okay. Then I did Good Morning Holy Spirit with Benga. Okay.
Amazing.
Okay. Mm. Okay. And we could find out on where can we get to
listen
to it?
They're all online. They're on iTunes, any of the social media platforms.
Hello, Happy. Good afternoon.
Okay, we have Happy from Suleri. Happy. Good afternoon. Hello.
Oh, please. I want to ask. She said that you need to have like 20 to 25 albums and then you pick up the best to release. So I want to ask, like, how many songs can you now, you know, you need to have for your release in your album?
Okay, you want to know how many songs she has or how many songs one can have in an album?
Yes, how many songs can one have in an album? Yes.
So how many songs can an artist, regardless of whether secular or gospel, can an artist have in an album? How many songs?
The list is 10.
Okay, you got that right?
Yes.
So if you don't have 10 songs, then you can't release any album?
It's not like you can't release any album. But for you to make your audience, you know, give them the best of you, I believe by the time they listen to one of to 10 of your songs, they'll be blessed. Mm-hmm. So when you know you have it, why not give it out? So, and in when you want to really, you know, go and check album, the minimum, at least, the minimum I've seen is 14.
14.
Is it we in Nigeria here, West Africa, that we do 10?
10.
Yes.
So, Happy, do you get that clear now?
Yeah.
Happy, are you into music?
Yeah.
Okay, I would like to hear from you when you're ready. DM me on Instagram at Blessed Omonose, okay?
Thank you.
All right, thank you so much for your call. I appreciate you. So your album now, the first one, it's already out.
Yeah.
Should your fans be looking out for a second album soon?
Yes, by God's grace.
This year?
Yes.
Amazing.
Yes.
Amazing.
I'm already working on it.
Wow.
And I have 2 singles out.
Oh, glory.
That's going to make the album. It's coming out by September.
Oh, glory. So if we're going to be getting those 2 singles by September, so when should we place our fingers that, okay, Jodiva album is coming out this year, what particular month of the year?
I'm looking at September.
September as well. Yes. So ladies and gentlemen, you've got the information officially on this platform, Super Screen Television, the Super Launch Gospel Vibes Jodiva album. Watch out for it. It's coming out this year. Do you have a title for it yet?
Yes, I
do. Would you want to release it?
Of course, I would like to.
So what's the title?
It's Throne Room of Grace album 2.
Throne Room
because
of Grace.
The first one is Throne Room of Grace.
Okay.
Album 1. So.
Throne Room of Grace album 2 will be dropping this year officially September by Jodiva. And trust us on this particular show, the Super Launch Gospel Vibes, we're definitely going to bring it out to you, tell you about it, and also give you information on where to get that particular album. But we have to wrap up now. Time is really not on our side. So what are your what do you have to say to those up and coming gospel artists who are looking up to you? How do you expect them to go about their musical career?
I would like to talk about them to put your trust in God. There's no need to be depressed when nobody cared about you. You know, you might be looking up to man, and especially gospel artists will always look up to church.
Mm.
Just look up to God and you have all that you want. It might take a while, but you will get there.
Okay, so
that dream that you have will come true.
Definitely it's gonna come true. It takes process. It takes process. Well, just go through the process, and with God by your side, it's definitely gonna come. So I want to say a big thank you to as many of you who took our time to be a part of the show. You tried to call in, but the phone number calls could not go in due to the weather. It's okay. Thank you, Happy, for your calls that went through. I'm BLEXED, Blessed of Monday. Say, follow me on Instagram at Blessed of Monday. Let's do it again, God willing, next week Monday. Ify.
I'll see you tomorrow. Follow me on Instagram at I am Ify Uba.
And that's our show for you. It's bye for now.
All right. Bye.